ivile imvumo ngawe
ivile imvumo ngawe.
Where would we be without black people? This is a story of a little boy named Theo who woke up one morning and asked his mother, "Mom, what if there were no black people in the world?" Well, his mother thought about that for a moment and then said, "Son, follow me around today and let's just see what it would be like if there were no black people in the world. Now go get dressed and we will get started." Theo ran to his room to put on his clothes and shoes. His mother took one look at him and said, "Theo, where are your shoes? Son, I must iron your clothes. Why are they so wrinkled?" When she reached for the ironing board, it was no longer there. You see, Sarah Boone, a black woman, invented the ironing board. And Jane E. Matzenlinger, a black man, invented the shoe lasting machine. "Oh well," she said, "please go and do something to your hair." Theo ran in his room to comb his hair, but the comb was not there. You see, Walter Simmons, a black man, invented the comb. Theo decided to just brush his hair, but the brush was gone. Lydia O. Newman, a black female, invented the brush. Well, this was a sight. Theo had no shoes, wrinkled clothes, his hair was a mess, even Mom's hair was a mess. Without the hair care inventions of Madam C.J. Walker, well, you get the picture. Mom told Theo, "Let's do our chores around the house and then take a trip to the grocery store." Theo's job was to sweep the floor. He swept and swept and swept. When he reached for the dustpan, it was not there. You see, Lloyd P. Ray, a black man, invented the dustpan. So he swept his pile of dirt over in the corner and left it there. He then decided to mop the floor, but the mop was gone. You see, Thomas W. Stewart, a black man, invented the mop. Theo yelled to his mom, "Mom, I'm not having any luck." "Well, son," she said, "let me finish washing these clothes and we will prepare a list for the grocery store." When the wash finished, she went to place the clothes in the dryer, but it was not there. You see, George T. Salmon, a black man, invented the clothes dryer. Mom asked Theo to go get a pencil and some paper to prepare their list for the market. So Theo ran for the paper and pencil, but noticed the pencil lead was broken. Well, he was out of luck because John Love, a black man, invented the pencil sharpener. Mom reached for a pen, but it was not there because William Carvers, a black man, invented the fountain pen. As a matter of fact, Lee Burridge invented the typewriting machine and W.A. Lovett, the advanced printing press. Theo and his mother decided to head out to the market. Well, when Theo opened the door, he noticed the grass was as tall as he was high. You see, the lawnmower was invented by John Burke, a black man. They made their way over to the car and found that it just wouldn't go. You see, Richard Spikes, a black man, invented the automatic gear shift, and Joseph Gamble invented the supercharged system for internal combustion engines. They noticed that the few cars that were moving were running into each other and having wrecks because there were no traffic signals. You see, Garrett A. Morgan, a black man, invented the traffic light. Well, it was getting late, so they walked to the market, got their groceries, and returned home. Just when they were about to put away the milk, eggs, and butter, they noticed the refrigerator was gone. You see, John Standard, a black man, invented the refrigerator, so they just left the food on the counter. By this time, Theo noticed he was getting mighty cold. Mom went to turn up the heat. However, Alice Parker, a black female, invented the heating furnace so they didn't have heat. Even in the summertime, they would have been out of luck because Frederick Jones, a black man, invented the air conditioner. It was almost time for Theo's father to arrive home. He usually took the bus, but there was no bus because its precursor was the electric trolley invented by another black man, Elbert R. Robinson. He usually took the elevator from his office on the 20th floor, but there was no elevator because Alexander Miles, a black man, invented the elevator. He also usually dropped off the office mail at a nearby mailbox, but it was no longer there because Philip Downing, a black man, invented the letter drop mailbox, and William Barry invented the postmarking and canceling machine. Theo and his mother sat at the kitchen table with their head in their hands. When the father arrives, he asks, "Why are you sitting in the dark?" "Why?" "Because Lewis Howard Latimer, a black man, invented the filament within the light bulb." Theo quickly learned what it would be like if there were no black people in the world. Not to mention, if he were ever sick and needed blood, Charles Drew, a black scientist, found a way to preserve and store blood, which led to his starting the world's first blood bank. And what if a family member had to have heart surgery? This would not have been possible without Dr. Daniel Hale Williams, a black doctor who performed the first open heart surgery. So you don't have to sit and wonder like Theo did, where would we be without black people in the world? It's pretty plain to see. It would be very bad.
Ngiphi 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 ng